my honey come back. Sometime I'm on a red back jack. Sometime I get a hump in my back.
Thick render of the grass, which using very heavy tessellation and very heavy geometry. Again, you will see like 1.5, 5.6 billion trackers on the screen. This demo, it's, by the way, pretty good for testing of LED stress test of the graphic card, because if you run it, believe me, in a couple of minutes, it will kill any graphic card because it's very, very, very tough. You can maybe hear it if you run for a couple of minutes that the fan of the car will go a little bit low, but I'm not sure. This case is pretty good. So, let me show you my favorite piece from tessellation. Will take a time, so go to the full screen. It's pretty amazing when you can do it. I mean, to be honest, first time I saw a really good grass, and I remember good, I said like, wow, it was, I guess, 3D Mark 2001 or something like this. If you remember, there was a demo around the kind of the lake, and it was like moving grass in the wind, and that was the first time I said, yeah, it looks really cool. But in compare to this one, it looks like from different galaxies, but of course it's like 7 years of development. But if you look here, I would love to show you, let me put the statistics. So if you look here, this number showing the amount of the triangles on the screen. Now we are around 100 billion. And of course it's increasing if you have a better view. But what I would like to show you, it's just the zoom, that it's not the texture of or anything like normal. You can zoom, really zoom, and go down to every single piece of the grass here, and everything is done by geometry. Can you imagine how many of these are on the screen? It's unbelievable. I can tell you, I can't wait to get the games for such level of the details. Can you imagine that you play it, you have a grass like this, and for example, I don't know, Call of Duty 3 or 4, whatever, the Modern Warfare, and then you see the soldiers fighting here, and even with the hairs tessellated, it would be pretty interesting. I think with the DirectX 11, of course, if developers will really utilize this, you can get or a really big step in the computer gaming. Unfortunately, of course, there will be always a little bit pushed back by consoles, but let's see what the next generation will bring up. So,
sometime I get a hump in my back.